We welcome you all to coverage for the NASCAR Busch Series here at the Memphis Motorsports Park for the running of the 2007 Samstown 250. We got a stacked lineup here today, and we're looking for a very exciting event. I'm Carter Jones, joined by Tanner Campos and Tyler Skozen. What are you guys anticipating for this event today?
Well, I'm definitely anticipating a lot of crazy action here. It's definitely one of my favorite racetracks here, and I think we're going to have a good show.
It's going to be one interesting show here in Memphis, Tennessee, and I expect a lot of chaos from start to finish because these drivers are looking to end the season on a strong note, and this Tennessee type of weather will definitely bring a lot of intensity for these drivers who are looking to end the year very strong.
You saw it right there. Marcos Ambrose got the pole, the typical road course ringer, getting the job done in qualifying here at Memphis. Now, here's rows 6 through 10. You guys notice anything that stands out to you?
Honestly, I'm going to be looking at the 26 there, Jamie McMurray. I feel like he's going to be fairly strong here today. I think he's going to be a good contender, especially late in the race.
There's one guy that really intrigues me, and that's Mr. Cale Gayle in row 10 and starting P19. I feel like that 33 car can easily make its way through traffic and possibly get it done here today.
Some other notables back here further in the pack, Brad Keselowski in the number 88 car, and David Reagan sharing row 13 with him as well.
Back here, another
row 16 through 20 as well.
Another driver I'll be looking at right there in row 20, the 60th car, Edwards. I think definitely starting a little bit further back probably than he wants, but I'm sure as the race goes on, he'll be up front and be a contender late.
There's one guy that I feel like who can pull off the upset, and that's Mr. Chase Austin starting from dead last. I feel like he's going to do the worst first challenge and get the job done here today.
A very intriguing comment right there. Chase Austin, look out for him today in that 64 machine. As the cars are double filed up here, and we're getting ready to go here from the Memphis Motorsports Park. What are your guys' winner predictions?
Oh, man, this is going to be a tough prediction, but I'm gonna go bold here. I'm gonna go with who I said earlier. I'm gonna go with the 26, Jamie McMurray.
I'm gonna go with the 33 of Cale Gayle.
I don't know who I'm going with, but green flags in the air. We're racing here at Memphis. So far, pretty orderly start. Up front, battle for the lead already. But on the inside, I don't know who that is.
Here comes David Rudin.
Things out. And Marcos Ambrose, David Rudiman on the high side, near contact, but Rudiman takes it away from Ambrose on the high side, and he will lead lap one.
Man, what a run by that 99 car. He is looking very fast today, and him getting around Marcos Ambrose early on is definitely showing that he's the car to beat.
And pretty orderly along the top five, top six even. The first battle you can see is for seventh back there, double file. But it looks as though Marcos Ambrose is going to continue to fall back here as he's on the back of him is the 38 car.
Yeah, definitely some pretty interesting already battle right here. You can see Marcos Ambrose trying to come back, and here's Carl Edwards trying to move his way up the field. Definitely a lot of cars in front of him. He's got to work by. He's got to be patient here to get by them all, but I definitely think he's going to get by them fairly soon here.
Patience is key here. If you try to make moves early on and try to put yourself in a wrong situation, you're easily going to have your day ended. So Carl has to be patient, or else he's going to end up taking an early exit from this race and possibly lose the chance of clinching the championship very early.
If patience is key, as Tanner alluded to. Carl Edwards currently running 39th. Here's the onboard from the Scotts cam. And you just see nothing but double file battles. And you just got to wait for that to sort out to make any moves on the competition without causing any incidents.
Yeah, that's the issue with Carl Edwards right now. They are all double file, and he can't be that aggressive and take them three wide early, or else it's going to really put him in a bad spot. So right now, he's kind of just boxed in behind everyone, not really able to go anywhere. But now they're all starting a single file out here. So now I think he could take his time, get by everyone one by one, and he'll be up front.
He's already making up some progress as he's basically surrounded by a bunch of lower cars and some of his teammates. I see Jay McMurray ahead of him, but Carl definitely has a fast car, but he has to be patient, like I said earlier on.
And the question is, how patient do you be, honestly? Because like you saw in that graphic there, he's already 10 seconds behind the leader after five laps. You think the risk is pretty high for getting lapped and perhaps getting trapped a lap down?
It is high here at Memphis Motorsports Park. And him being 10 seconds behind the race leader is definitely going to put some pressure on him. But he knows he has a fast car, so he definitely has to use some of that patience early on. But worrying about the leader is definitely not a big deal at the moment for Carl, but it's something he'll have to keep in his head.
As we go through 3 and 4 here, Edwards continuing to pick away at him. He's, oh, smoke on the front stretch, and we got a spinner, the 72 car. And the caution will fly here. I believe that is DJ Kennington.
He's got some damage on the rear end.
Yeah, just a slight tap on the right rear with the inside wall there. Didn't look like too much other contact. We'll have to see what set it off, though.
That's what we were talking about with Carl Edwards. That's why he shouldn't have been aggressive. Let's see what happened here. And yeah, definitely on this replay, he's already sideways into the grass. So kind of tough to see what happened there. But thankfully, Carl wasn't up there, you know, that far out being that aggressive. We'll see if we can get a better angle here. Looks like he may have gotten hooked from the car behind.
It definitely looked like he got bumped from behind. It's that typical short track madness here at Memphis Motor Sports Park. If you make one mistake early on, especially on the front stretch, you can easily go around.
We'll be back after a break. All right, welcome back here for the NASCAR Busch Series in the Samstown 250 here at Memphis Motorsports Park. I'm Carter Jones alongside Tanner Campos and Tyler Skozen. Man, we got one caution so far on the day for about 10, 11 laps. And as we ride under the pace laps here, what did you guys notice in those first few green flag laps of action we had?
Well, I definitely saw a mix of hard, aggressive racing, but yet a lot of patience. You saw a lot of guys sprung out, like you see Dario Franchitti right there. He was in a mix of a lot of single-file race cars, but towards middle, back into the pack, you saw a lot of guys who were sideways and really being aggressive early.
Yeah, Dario Franchitti is a really big deal right now, just fresh off his Indy 500 win and also his championship. He's really just one of the hottest drivers in America right now. And here he is racing the number 42 car in the Nationwide Series, or rather Busch Series.
That's next year, but Dario Franchitti definitely has a resume outside of NASCAR. And him giving NASCAR a chance will definitely be very intriguing to see, as he's doing good so far. But let's see how the three-star will go to see if his talents are still fully up to par.
Yes, we will see how this restart goes. David Ruderman will lead him back to the green flag here as he continues his reign of 14 laps led. Here comes the 59 once again to his bumper. Marcos Ambrose trying to get it back after it was stolen away from him on lap number one.
Marcos Ambrose definitely being aggressive early, and you can also see there Jason Loeffler, he's been on the back bumper. Marcos Ambrose early on those restarts, also on board with Loeffler here. You got a good run off the corner, a little bit of block there.
And more trouble appears.
Oh, yeah,
I don't know who that is. And we got another car going backwards on the racetrack.
What is going on?
Dude, you're going the wrong way. Turn around.
I don't think that's legal, but Bobby Hamilton Jr. thinks it is. Team Renzi Motorsports 35 machine as he continues to go backwards here.
Bobby.
I can't say that's the smartest thing.
He's not
I
the
think
brightest.
I'm going to have a trip to the NASCAR Hall after this one. Here's the other car. No, sorry, that's the same car.
Yeah.
I don't know what he's attempting right now.
I think he's trying to go to McDonald's or something. Well, that's a sponsor then, so it does
okay,
make
turn
sense.
Around.
I'm not sure why he went the whole turns 2 and 1 to turn around. Maybe he's trying to get to the exit of pit road. No, he just drove by it. I don't know what he's thinking in that little brain of his.
You can definitely see a lot of damage to that left front. Tire definitely looks flat, and you can definitely see the fenders all bent up there. But
but we'll be back here for the Samstown 250. All right, and welcome back. We got restart number 3 on the burner here as we get ready to go. Bobby Hamilton Jr. was the cause of the last caution. And green flag back in the air.
Good restart there for Ruderman and Marcos Ambrose there. Got a pretty good jump on the third place cars.
Leffler definitely did not have a great restart right there, but he's still right behind Ambrose. He does have the speed to get around that 59 car, but he just hasn't found the right time to get around him at the moment. But this restart is definitely going to be interesting to see if he can try to make that move.
Coleman in the 18 as well, hanging in the 38's rear view here, as Ruderman continues to put it to him after 20 laps of action at Memphis.
Definitely looks like Loeffler is honestly a little bit quicker than Marcos Ambrose. I've definitely been watching the way he's been running, and he definitely seems like he's been better, as he is still right on the back bumper. Can't seem to get that exit speed off the corner. Definitely going to send it in here pretty deep, get right on the bumper of Ambrose, almost contact there.
He has the speed through entering the corner, but he just cannot find that perfect straightaway speed to get around that 59 car, as he's not really, he's all right in turns 3 and 4, but turns 1 and 2 is definitely his bread and butter, as he's going to try to go for it heading into turn 1, but I don't know if he'll be able to get around that 59 car. He's just basically blocking every single line around him.
All right, here's a word with this dude.
The 28, I looked at my mirrors in the 14, drive down the bottom, 3 wide on a short track. I think he got in the 28, hit me, but that's no big surprise to me dealing with the 14. I've dealt with him before, you know. I just, probably just another loser deal with grandmother. Grandpa got a bunch of money, got him in a decent race car when I'm taking me out. So, you deal with it, you just deal with it.
You hear the frustration, the team working hard to try to get it back together so Bobby Hamilton can get back out, but it's going to be a while.
Yeah. You guys have been mentioning with that 38 car, it looks like he's got tons more speed than the 59 as he tries to get around him. As we look at Edwards back here in the pack yet again, moved up at least 10 spots. But is there any concern for wear on the front tires when you dive it in that deep into the corner every lap?
It's pretty risky around here. When you try to dive bomb it into a corner, you'll basically use up half that tire. But if you like to be calm during certain parts of the corner, like let off in the center of the turn, you can easily save at least a lap or two of rubber throughout the race. But when you use it up a lot early on, you're definitely putting yourself in a tough position to succeed in this race.
Battles all across the racetrack, still through turns 1 and 2, got multiple side-by-side battles. Carl in one of them right now as he gets around the 56 on the high line, or tries to. He will clear him. Up ahead, you see the 9 car. I think that's Chase Miller, if I'm correct.
That is correct.
As he's falling back on the high line. Here's another battle here. Now the couple battles. This is the... Man, you know, quality back in these days, man, I tell you what, it's kind of hard to read the numbers, especially when it's pink on pink here, but I believe that's the 21 car.
That is the 21.
McCready or something like that. I don't know who a McCready is. Tim McCready. You guys want to talk about Tim McCready?
Oh, yeah, I do. I raced against him in iRacing just last Tuesday, and I'd say he was a very aggressive racer. That was for sure, and very fun.
The dude was supposed to offer me a McDonald's meal, but I never got it, but it's whatever. At least he showed up here today. I'll meet him after the race, so you better be ready.
I think Bobby Hamilton Jr. stole all the McDonald's meals, if I'm being honest. Bit of contact looked like right there as they jammed up a tad through turns 3 and 4. Guy's getting really aggressive. Perhaps 3-wide move here.
Oh.
Thinks better of it. That is the 26 car of Jamie Mack.
Yeah, Jamie's definitely been another driver I've been trying to watch in this race. Definitely been a little all over the place, honestly.
Here's the 36. Eric McClure started dead last. No, sorry, not dead last. Started 40th. There's 43 cars. But Eric McClure.
That was Jeremy Clements.
Oh, there goes Loeffler.
Oh, yeah. I thought that.
I apologize. Yeah, Loeffler finally making the move.
Now I think this is Loeffler's time. He definitely seems like he's been one of the fastest cars. So now let's see if he's going to be able to run down David Ruderman here for the lead coming up. But now he's got to hold off everyone behind him.
I think he has the speed to easily hold off everyone behind him. But Marcos Ambrose fell like a rock during that entire process. And now that Loeffler has clean racetrack ahead of him, other than David Ruderman, I think that 38 car might have something to say.
It sure appears the 59 team set their car up for more qualifying rather than race setup. So it's kind of showing here he may be falling back because they were more set up for speed in the initial qualifying session. They're not quite set up for the race here today. Either that or they have a lot of adjustments to make to catch up with the racetrack. Shannon Spakes reporting. Don't care about that. We're more important than her right now.
Yeah, we're more important. She can be quiet. Yeah.
Brad Coleman here, up the third. I mentioned him hanging in the top four. Now it looks like he's hounding down on the 38, or at least sticking with him.
I feel like this race is about to get a lot more interesting because I saw some lap cars in the way. So this is going to be an interesting sequence of events for David Ruderman.
Ruderman the leader as we go to break. Keep it with us. Top five right there. And welcome back here. We have had an incident. The 99 is on pit road, and the 41 we saw that was very slow on the track. And actually, this is pit stops happening as we have been under caution. So cars getting their adjustments made, tires changed, and here's the 18 of Coleman getting his service done.
Yeah, we do believe we saw an incident there. Not sure. I believe that was Brian Clausen that had an issue. Not too sure. He seemed like he was slow on the outside, but everyone coming off pit road. Let's see the race off pit road. Maybe Ruderman will keep his track position. We'll see.
The 11, I think that might be Keller. I don't know. I'm not professional. Yep. Okay, cool. I'm proud of myself.
You did it.
Some other cars going to make their way onto pit road as we're looking to get a replay up for you guys as to with what happened with the 41 of Brian Clausen. I still don't know why I thought the 36 was Eric McClure.
I mean, he was zero.
Oh, here we go.
Here we go. Ooh, it looks like there was a bit of contact. Spun on the inside of someone, barely getting by on the inside of the 41. There looked like the 20.
Here we go.
I don't know. 25. Oh, yeah. They're right in front right there. Oh, wow.
Looked like the 25, I believe. Trying to crowd Brian Clausen on the inside, not giving him much room. Got him sideways there.
That's just another case of short track madness.
And check this dude out.
Mm.
Brian Keselowski, lucky dog here at Memphis, as the caution flew, and he was the first car one lap down, so he will return to the lead lap.
Oh, we have
here we go. I guess we're going. Ryan Young, the current race leader, after not pitting, it appears.
Close. It's Ron Young, but yeah, same thing. Oh, and here comes Ruderman.
It
the
guy
who just brought us to pit road. Yeah, but David Ruderman just got his pit road. On the outside is going to clear Young for the lead.
Trouble on the back stretch. Turned in front of the pack. It's Kyle Kriseloff in the 14 car. Caution flies for the fourth time today here at Memphis.
Oh,
what was that?
He just looked like he got dumped. I don't know what happened. Ooh, there.
Deliberately.
Whoever that had every look of being dumped, honestly, just hooked to the right. I'm surprised that wasn't a massive crash. It was just like
too.
A one-car incident. I see a little haul it around through turns three and four, bring it to pit road, see if that can be salvageable for the rest of today.
He can try, but that honestly doesn't seem like it's the best thing. Let's see what happened here. Let's see if he got. Let's see what happened to get have Crystal off into the wall. Slow car in front.
Bit of a bottleneck right there.
Oh, he just
what in the world?
Oh yeah, that is definitely obvious. He just flat out turned him over a small incident. That was whoever that drives that 28 car really needs to be parked for at least two or three laps.
I couldn't tell if that was
parked
20...
for this race and maybe the rest of the season for that.
I couldn't tell if that was the 29 or so. That's what I thought. If that was me, that if it was, I believe that was Scott Wimmer there. Yeah, he just hooked a dead left
turn.
Chris Law into
crazy.
The wall.
Another car making a bit of contact. I'm not sure who that was with the 14 as he was backwards, but
yeah. So definitely, I believe looked like it was Scott Wimmer that turned the 14 there, Chris Law into the wall. Oh, no, it was the 28, okay.
Yeah, it was the 28, it looks like. It. I'll have to identify that as Robert Richardson Jr.
Mm. I don't know what you were doing there, Robert. Don't know what that was. Sorry,
he
Scott.
He will get the better of him.
Didn't mean to say it, Scott.
Actually, I just received word he's being black flagged by NASCAR.
I'm not surprised.
Really? Yeah.
Yes,
I'm not surprised either.
No, that was probably one of the most intentional things I've seen in a good while, I'd say.
Lap 44 of 250 laps, and we're pulling this crap. I mean, that's really saying something about the driver of this 28 car. As they continue to assess Kyle Kriseloff's damage here, the Lily Diabetes machine. And pull out some fenders for the 28 as well.
And the officials holding him.
Imagine in McKinney, Texas, that you have to get, that you got black flagged, like, imagine.
I mean, his sponsor is Checkers, after all, and he became a wrecker today.
Yeah, pretty much.
No kidding. Well, here's Carl Edwards in the Scott's machine. He's been making his way uptown, up through the pack, As you see the safety truck there cleaning up a little bit, getting some debris off the track as necessary to get the racetrack back in raceable condition. They're looking to go green again this time by, so truck's pulling off, so that's a good sign. I believe we will be going back to green here.
Let's see what we saw there on that last restart. We saw David Ruderman just pretty much, you know, fly to the lead on the outside. Let's see if he's going to be able to do the same thing here.
He's going to fly away because Ron Young's still in second, so he might be holding up third and fourth and beyond behind him.
Green flag back out here. Restart number five on the day. Technically restart number four because the first one's the initial start.
Yeah.
If we want to get technical.
There you saw Marcus Ambrose back there. He's a little bit further back than probably he expected. He's definitely going to have his work paid out here to try to get back to the front.
Oh, contact! The 71 from, second place, stayed out earlier in the race, and then just got sent around right there. That will bring out the yellow flag yet again.
Well, then. Well, now he actually gets the chance to pit.
I mean, yeah, he has to pit now since someone spun him out. I guess they were tired of seeing him in the way, so I guess they wanted to get him out of the way early on.
He got nailed.
Yeah. I wonder if this was like the previous caution, like when Kyle Kriseloff got dumped. I wonder if it's the same thing and Young just got dumped here. Let's see. Oh.
Oh, yeah. Coleman. This would be the case.
Coleman just dumped him.
I mean, he was getting back on the throttle and the 71 was really going.
Yeah, I mean, Brad Coleman, he was, I don't know. Brad Coleman really got into the throttle early, especially with those, Young staying out there. He's able to get back to the throttle quicker, but whew. Well then.
Cautions. Three cautions.
Impressive for not hit the wall like that, really, though.
Tanner brings up a good point. Cautions breed cautions here. So far, five on the day, just barely a fifth through the race. Keep it with us as you look at the 18 of Brad Coleman in the Carino's car. All right, we're back racing here, apparently, in the Samstown 250. David Ruderman once again holding everyone at bay. As second place currently, trying to track down and keep the 99 in his sights and perhaps try and grab the lead from him, is the 18 of Brad Coleman.
Ooh, there's some intensity right there. I see some potential football. I don't know who's making a move right there.
Oh, that three-wide move didn't look okay. I thought that was risky, but yeah, I guess they're fine.
On board of J.J. Yaley in the number 20 has fallen back just a bit, down three spots from where he started in the top 10.
Ooh,
sliding up the track there as well as the Geico machine. I believe that's Mike Wallace, if I'm not mistaken.
That was the Wallace boys right there. I believe Stephen Wallace got shuffled.
Oh, look at the middle.
A little bit.
Ooh.
And that I think down. He still getting shuffled.
That was a really good move. First he got to the inside, car getting went up the track, and then he just peeked his way to the outside, and now he sits in 12th.
He's clenched funny. Cheeks moments happening here all across the racetrack at Memphis Motorsports Park. You see the tack and all that good fancy stuff here in this graphic on J.J. Yaley now as the interval between he and the leader, David Ruderman, continues to grow. The 90 machine here, the City Financial Bank machine. I don't know who that is, but they're doing all right. Was that a bit of smoke coming from the 20, or am I just imagining things?
I don't know. Imagining things.
Okay. Oh, it must be a bit of speedy dry, because I kind of see something coming from most of the cars. But yeah, the 90 car, Stephen Light, that's who it is, started 18th, and he's on a move.
Oh,
five spots trouble. As the yellow is back out.
What do we got? Wait. Oh, car spawned.
Oh, stretch. Identify who this one is. Is that Carl?
No, that's not Carl.
No, it's not.
Oh, it's the 37 John Graham.
I thought I saw the Scots logo for some reason.
Nah, Carl's stayed away from trouble. Oh, that night car has some rear end damage. I don't know where he got that.
Yeah, he does.
I don't think that was there before. Could it have been from the 05 machine, perhaps?
No, Carl looks okay. Brett Rowe, Carl looks fine to me.
Well, okay, we're showing him because he's the free pass. Okay, gotcha.
Ah,
all right.
Okay.
Oh, fun times here. There's the NASCAR official. And we'll be back after another break because we don't have a replay at the moment. And we're back green here for the Samstown 250 here at Memphis Motorsports Park in Tennessee. Tanner, you know, you're a great and humble Tennessee native. What's it like racing here at Memphis?
This racetrack is definitely very interesting.
I'm sorry to cut you off, but man, they keep wrecking. They're not going to throw the yellow, though, it appears. So we're going to keep racing here after the spin.
The 43. But yeah, like I said early on before I was interrupted a moment, this track is very interesting. As you know, Short Track Madness has definitely been picking up a lot. But I love racing here. It's probably one of my favorite short tracks to ever visit. And I love coming to Memphis and seeing all these great people watching this great action here at the park.
Hometown pride definitely running through the veins of Tanner. And understandably so. There's the replay with the 43. Got tapped and turned around exiting turn two.
You just got the bun out, plain and simple.
Yep, pretty much.
Yep, no other explanation other than that. Nope. We've been seeing a lot of that so far today.
Yeah.
Brad Keselowski on the outside of J.J. Yaley here as they battle for a spot. That would be 11th or 12th place.
That would be 11th. He could go for 10th since Mike Wallace is ahead of him.
Yeah, you Mike Wallace.
Can I point out Brad Keselowski? He is a driver that I have definitely been keeping my eye on the last couple months to see how he is. And I honestly see him as, like, a bust in the, you know, in the highest rank of NASCAR. What do you guys think?
I honestly agree. I don't see him going much places in life.
Okay. Y'all are a little hard on the kid. He's got potential. Dale Earnhardt Jr. did not pick him up for a reason. He sees something that we don't. And I feel like Brad Keselowski could do something very good for this sport, and I'm very intrigued to see what he can do in the future.
You know, Brad Keselowski, you know who he reminds me of as we were on a very nice lap? Reminds me of a very similar Ryan Newman for some reason. I wonder if anything, you know, they'll be battling in the future and, you know, maybe something in the, I don't know what could happen. What do you think?
It's possible. I can see some similarities where you're getting from with Ryan Newman. I mean, he could be a good qualifier, so that's one benefit for being a Ryan Newman type of driver.
Of course, with Brad Keselowski, brother Brian Keselowski got the free pass earlier in this race. Don't know where he is now, but yeah, pretty cool to see brothers racing in the same race, you know, always pretty cool.
Here comes Dale Gale behind him, trying to get around Stephen White. I haven't seen him all day.
This is possibly the most orderly we've been so far on the day. As you see Colin Brown in 16th, 8 seconds back from the leader.
Been pretty calm.
Calm me down after the intense string of cautions early in this race. I think we're 6 cautions in as we have yet to be a third of the way through this event.
I will say what I have been noticing in this race, we have had lots of cautions and a lot of spins going on as we're seeing Carl Edwards here, but one thing that I am noticing, no matter the situation, David Ruderman has a really fast race car right now.
Oh, definitely. David Ruderman is the car to beat. We thought Leffler had something for him, but he's been in traffic, so it seems like no one has anything for that 99 car. But even with Carl Edwards climbing his way through traffic, we don't even know if he'll be able to get anywhere near that 99 car when he gets up there.
There's the points as of now. Carl Edwards is taking it away as we have another incident on the racetrack, bringing out the 7th caution on the day. Let's see. 40 car.
40. The 40, that's Matt Carter.
Son of Travis Carter, former Cup Series owner.
Yeah, for Specialty Motorsports, mind you.
I will say that unfortunately there was not a very special moment, unfortunately, for in there.
Take a look at what happened, because we actually got a replay here, and it appears... further back.
Oh.
Got turned around by another car and keeps it out of the wall. Good job by Matt Carter.
Now that was special.
Looks like he'll be all right for the day as we're going to go to commercial yet again. There are the big... we're probably not going to commercial. My bad. Anyway, yeah, the biggest movers on the day. We saw Carl Edwards start way back there, as well as Chase Austin. He's been gaining lots of spots, as Tanner predicted.
I told y'all, do not sleep on Chase Austin. This guy is talented as heck. And I feel like he has a chance to win this race. Just give him some time. These cautions are helping him a lot as well, so it's a possibility he can get it done.
If Chase really wants to get this race done, he's got to find... I mean, I've been looking at it a lot of times. He's got to find something, because right now the two cars like that have the best speeds are David Rudiman and Carl Edwards, so he's really going to need to find something to beat those two.
Is it me, or did that picture of Chase Austin remind you guys of Zach Stern?
A little bit. I could see where you're coming from.
Yeah. I mean, they're probably brothers, even though they have different names. Yeah. But they're probably some form of cousins.
Dario Franchitti continuing to have a pretty swell day here, currently running fourth as we return back to green flag conditions here.
Not even close to halfway in this race yet. And how many cautions have we had? Seven?
Seven in total.
These guys really need to... They're going to need to calm down a little bit. I know this is a somewhat difficult track, but that's a lot, I'll be honest. As here comes Leffler and Marcus Ambrose, like we've seen these guys battling a lot earlier.
In case you were curious, seven in Spanish translates to siente or something like that.
I did not know that in my life. Thanks, I appreciate that.
I didn't know the phrase of a Spanish class.
Oh, and caution again!
Oh, the 64 machine. He had gained so much ground, and now he's going to have to make it back up again. Assuming he doesn't have too much damage, he should be fine.
Commentator's
it doesn't look
curse.
Like he has much damage.
Yeah, I guess. Commentator's curse. I mean...
Oh, no. That makes me worry. Is Jamie McMurray going to spin out later?
Oh, no.
I hope so.
Wow, you're gonna do Jamie like that? Okay,
you'll be fine. That one's a tough one.
All right, well, we'll see if we can get any angle on what happened here with the 64 of Chase Austin. As I mentioned, was having a pretty good day, making his way up through the pack, kind of following Carl Edwards through.
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
Nope.
Maybe not. Yeah, nope, or not. Maybe. Oh, wait. All right.
I don't know.
All right, cool.
Okay. Looks like we're just maybe going to go green?
Yeah, something like that.
Okay, then.
You're looking at the good old Carinos. You know, have you guys been to Johnny Carino's?
I have not.
Me
what
neither.
About you?
I have once. I went there for senior prom, actually. It was pretty dang good. As we restart here, David Rudiman once again with the superior launch on Brad Coleman. Oh, dive into the inside for fourth or fifth place. I didn't see who that was.
I didn't either.
David Rudiman is just basically launched away at this point. But
is that Leffler?
You're going to
Leffler on the number 22 machine.
I thought Leffler was about to get into 22. That would have been unfortunate.
I'm something. Leffler has definitely got that speed. And he's showing, he's sneaking back into the picture a little bit. But he's
still caught. Oh, no! Chase Austin again! Oh, you know, sometimes you have a good day, then it goes to a bad day, and then it goes to a terrible day, and I think that's what Chase Austin is currently experiencing.
A lot heavier damage this time. Definitely looks like it's going to be a pretty much ending day right there after that. It's like pretty significant.
I mean,
he
could possibly
damage.
Fix on pit road, but it's definitely going to look like it's going to go beneath the wall.
His speed that he's had all day, you know, one of the biggest movers, definitely that speed's going to be done, I'd assume.
Just like that, Tanner's prediction is down the toilet, unfortunately. Let's not in
see.
Any way that he should have deserved. As you see, he spun into turn one, I believe, and then backed it into the wall, and that's
it
pretty...
Looks, I couldn't really tell there. It looks like he kind of spun all by himself. Not really too sure, and it looks like he's bringing it to the garage. Pretty much looks like he might be done for the day.
Is this a sign of things to come? Last year, we had 16 cautions for 98 caution laps. So far today, we've had 9, and we have yet to be a third of the way through the race.
Yeah.
I mean, actually, we are just over a third of the race, actually.
Let's put it this way. We're not even 100 laps in yet.
Whoa, what is this?
What's going on there between Coleman and the 64?
Well, he was just trying to block Brett Coleman to get into his pit box. I don't know what that was about.
You saw the hand out the window for Brad Coleman, giving him a gesture as well.
I wonder if anything happened between these two earlier on the race, but I don't really know much involving these two, but interesting decision by Brad Coleman to come down pit road.
Maybe yeah, he feels like he doesn't have that much of a short run car, so he's going to get some adjustments. Maybe it looks like they're maybe going to pull the hood up here.
No, I think they were repair damaged from early on. I believe he got into the back of Ron.
He
haven't really attended to that damage, so this is definitely a great opportunity.
Yeah, you can definitely see that left front damage there a little bit, and the hood kind of bent in on the Carino's car there.
Yeah. So it appears the only person that could really keep up with David Rudiman was the 18 of Brad Coleman, but now he's going to be further back, mired in traffic now that he's taken the repair time on this front of the 18 car. So, where's Carl Edwards is the question. I think he's probably the next guy we'd consider that could put a fight up against the 99 car.
Leaderboard says he's in 12th place. We still got a little bit of traffic to make his way up to the front here, but, I mean, we've seen guys all the way back there. He started way back in the 40s, 30s, and he's already up to 12th. I think he'll be up there fine.
Robert Richardson Jr. involved in a prior accident. Gonna get the lucky dog here and get back on the lead lap.
Probably wanted his multiple laps. I believe he went at least two laps.
Would not be surprised. I think unless you're involved in an incident, you're probably not getting whacked in this race with how many cautions there are.
Oh, my God.
Speaking of which, green flag back in the air here. Rudiman once again with a good jump.
There's one person I'm going to be trying to watch in this restart, seeing where they're going to be able to go, because they seem like they have one of the best short run cars. Oh, Jason Keller
with the 22 car. Who's the 22, by the way? I'm kind of bad with identity.
That's a good question. Really, let me find that out. That's Mike.
Whoever it is, he's definitely put up a fight.
That's the 22 of Mike Bliss there.
Mike Bliss, okay. That's pretty neat.
Good battling there with Jason Keller. Definitely, they're being aggressive there. And you can see Jason Leffler, probably one of the better cars on a short run here. We've had a lot of those today, so...
Watch for Leffler right here. He's getting aggressive once again with corner entry, as we alluded to earlier in this event. Closer look at the 22 here. Mike Bliss. Kept the car rather clean. It looks like there might be a little bit of something that happened there to the left rear. Can't quite tell. But, yeah. No, it looks fine, actually. Hello.
I mean, he does have damage. He's looking pretty fast, so it doesn't look like it's affecting that super clips car. So I guess he's got something for the competition.
In fact, it might even be helping him a little bit.
Yeah.
Am I the only one that gets real SpongeBob vibes from Mike Bliss's 22 car right there?
I think I'm getting more like, I know there's like a blue that doesn't match. Or actually, is there, I don't know. I'm getting more vibes to like the 51 Rick Ware racing car. And there's a
trouble.
Big crash.
Two cars around the backstretch. Check out the situation here. And Ron Young in the 71 car.
And neither of them are going to stay on the lead lap.
Chase Miller,
yep,
Ron
both
Young.
Both lapped right there. And Ron Young in the RB1 Motorsports 71 machine is going to keep it parked to the inside barrier here as the safety trucks once again come out for... I'm losing track. Are we at number 9 or 10?
We've got to be at 10. Okay, 9, 10, whatever. Let's see here what happened.
Oh, the 47!
Oh, Ron, look out! That's unfortunate for Chase there. Nowhere really to go. Let's see if we can get a better view here. Oh, yeah, Ron got turned. Look out.
What's it like as a driver? You just can't see anything. Just
I've been in situations like that before, and at that point, when you just see smoke in front of you, best thing to do is to hold the wheel, make sure nothing hits you, hold your line, and hold the brake, and make sure nothing hits you. That's pretty much all you can do at that point, and rely on your spotter to give you good information.
There's Ron Young moving again.
Pretty unfortunate day for Ron Young. I don't know how many instances he's been in today. Was this 2 or 3 now?
I think this is like his second.
Yeah.
Or 2? Okay.
Yeah, he's been in 2.
He was the one that got spun for Chris, spun earlier.
Yeah,
he
went early on.
All right, well, once again, zeroing in on the 42 of Dario Franchitti here, who continues to have a pretty splendid day. I've always loved those Target number 42 colors. I don't know about you guys. It's pretty sexy.
They are pretty sexy. I can agree with that.
I agree, too.
Oh, here comes Jason Keller.
All right, Jason Keller. Let's see. Definitely another interesting piece of strategy here. I'm going to be honest here. I feel like those, if you are ones deciding to pit, you're like one of the few, and you're going to be put way back in traffic, definitely going to be a risky maneuver with all the incidents that have been happening mid-pack here.
Is strategy more critical in races with these abundance of unpredictable cautions?
I guess you could say they are. I mean, they are, like you said, very unpredictable, and it's hard to tell. So, I mean, I guess at some points during the race, you're going to have to make some different strategies.
That's all you can really do. Because the chaos has definitely been insane in this race. So we got to be more calm when we get down to the nitty-gritty.
Chaos is aplenty, and we'll return after the break. We're racing again! Because we don't know when to come back before the restart happens. But anyway, David Runeman has led practically every lap. I think all but four, I think that graphic said. He's just been dominating. And it's pretty easy to dominate. I mean, when you got a fast car and just an abundance of yellows.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, that's the only way you can really dominate this race is basically being out front and let the chaos happen behind you. And David Runeman has definitely mastered it today.
I will say, though, Runeman may have a tiny bit of a challenge at some point in this race. And the crush is out again.
For Jeremy Clements, I got it right that time. Jeremy Clements in the 36 with heavy damage to the rear of that machine.
I was just about to say, I thought we were going to have a longer run here, but... Never mind.
That's what we're meant to do.
Heavy damage. This may kind of look like earlier a day ender here for Jeremy Clements. Another driver was on the move, having a decent day, and definitely going to end in a pretty unfortunate way.
Yeah, you saw those rookie stripes on that 36 machine. Just getting going here in his NASCAR career. Who knows where his career is going to take him as we look at the replay here, entering turn number one. It appears as though they made contact. Who was that?
I couldn't tell. All I saw was a yellow car, but I didn't really get much out of it.
I'm not sure. Oh,
I think that's
the 77 Brandon Miller. I guess we could see Jeremy's not very happy after that.
No. I mean, I don't blame
them. They may not be done.
Oh, they're right next to each other. Oh.
They're not done.
They need to calm down. Oh, there goes Jeremy.
And you saw that graphic. We are about to break a record for most cautions. This is already number 11.
It appears as though we may just easily eclipse this because we're not even halfway through this race. We're only two off time. So keep it tuned here as we watch the rest of this interesting race unfold.
Just to let y'all know, I believe Jeremy Clements has been penalized for his actions.
I would not be surprised.
Yeah, me neither. I will say that sucks for Brandon Miller. That's a nice race car.
I agree. The silver complements the yellow and black Dollar General so very well. And you guys know me. I love a good Dollar General scheme.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Man, it looks like he almost stalled it, Eric. Looks
like that guy wanted to ride, and he didn't want to let him go.
All right, well, as things get sorted back out here, a lot of sorting that has to happen in these races with millions of cautions, especially when they happen one after the other after the other.
Props to the 36 crew for Jeremy Clements. Looks like they actually got that car fixed fairly well.
They did a pretty good job.
Looking forward to seeing how he fares to the rest of the race.
I will say right before we restart here, I'm noticing even though David Runeman is leading, but now that 42 Dario Franchitti is right there in second place. I think he could possibly give David Runeman a run for his money. We'll have to see.
I mentioned Carl possibly be the only person that could contend with Runeman, but I mean this 42 car has been strong as well.
If there's anyone to compete with Runeman, I'd say it's either Franchitti, Edwards, or Leffler.
There's a guy talking. Green flag back in the air.
And solid restart by that 42. He's definitely got a decent start, but he's not up to par with that 99.
Mm-mm.
Not only that, but a clean restart as well. We are single file. I think everyone's just wanting to take a break. That is not the case if someone goes around. It's the 66 of Stephen Wallace.
Well.
And he's got some damage like Chase Austin does.
And he's going backwards, too.
Now he's pulling up Bobby Hamilton Jr.
Yep. He's doing...
Well, I tell you what. This is something. We were totally single file pretty much on that restart. We still can't keep him straight.
I just want you to know that we are now one caution away from tying the record.
That is true. Here's what happened. Brad Keselowski.
What did I tell you earlier? What did I tell you earlier?
That's just a similar case to what happened earlier with Brad Coleman and Ron Young.
Yeah.
So Brad got on the brakes, got on the gas a lot early while Stephen Wallace was on the brakes. It was one of those situations that unfortunately led to Stephen suffering the same fate like his teammate early on.
Mm-hmm. Got a fantastic crowd on hand here at Memphis as we're getting the one to go here before the restart, I think, maybe.
Yeah, one to go to tying the record, I know.
And now Brad's being penalized.
Yep, here comes Brad.
They're penalizing him a lap, I believe.
Are we gonna have any cars left in this race?
I mean,
probably at the rate we're going at, I'd expect maybe four finishing by the end of this.
That would be something.
Definitely gonna pull out some, fix some damage here for Brad Keselowski.
Yeah, Keselowski, obviously sponsored by the Navy. As we go green here, David Rudiman on the, I was gonna say front row, but it's a row to himself because we have single file restarts. Yeah,
yeah.
Pretty cool, right? Yeah, we're green here. Moves being made yet again to the apron!
JJ Yaley.
That was the 20 car of JJ Yaley. And that's a winner. We saw on one day with Jimmy McMurray, it's Landon Castle in the 5.
Well, no car. There's
a development driver.
We have tied the record, ladies and gentlemen. We are tied for most cars.
Oh, that's crazy. Landon Castle, the 5 car for Hendrick Motorsports. Been slightly of a disappointment, but I feel like there's a ton of just untapped potential in this
person. I agree.
He can still turn the boat around, but this has definitely not been one of his better performances as we're looking at a replay.
The 2 cars spun, it looked like.
I will defend Jamie McMurray here a little bit. There did seem like there was a lot of check up there, and he was not prepared for that.
There was certainly a bottleneck that happened there. It looked like Castle made contact with the car in front of him. I'm not sure if he actually spun out. He may have kept going straight, but it looked like he was totally sideways as well.
He definitely looked like he was a little sideways before McMurray got into the back of him, but that pretty much finished him off. Not too sure what caused that checkup, but an unfortunate break for Landon.
Certainly. Yeah, I think the flagman's getting a raise after this race.
He's probably a little...
arm workout as well.
That's for sure. He's definitely getting his work paid off for this one.
The yellow fever is crazy so far. Jamie McMurray getting work done after being involved in that 1-2 car spin.
And just to remind you all, ladies and gentlemen, we are not even halfway through the race, and we already have, 13 cautions?
Yep, the caution tie, I think.
About another 15 laps, and then we'll hit halfway. Another 15 laps, if we can make it there.
Yep. Carl Edwards... He hasn't really had the opportunity to gain much ground. I think he needs better restarts, and if he can't get those, he just needs a green flag run. But we haven't really been able to assess how cars do on the long run, like who has the better short run car and who has the better long run car, because there's just been so many yellows that's impossible to assess.
I will say the thing that is benefiting Carl here for making him move up the leaderboard is all these guys in front of him either getting into an incident or bringing it to pit road, depending on the strategy. So definitely is probably helping into Carl's strategy. He's probably going to keep staying out here because I assume he probably has not used his tires, I'd say, that much. because we haven't had that long of a run, so it depends on how aggressive he's been, but already into the top 10, maybe going to be a threat later, whenever that is.
Yeah. Oh, man. There's Scott Wimmer.
That's also a nice race car.
Right? That is a pretty nice looking race car, and Scott Wimmer has definitely turned his career around here in the Xfinity Series. Well, Busch Series, to be exact. I don't know what it's going to be.
Safety truck still on the track. We'll go another lap under caution. But yeah, you ever been to Holiday Inn, guys? Just like, you know, any hotel, just go for a swim or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I've been in the Motel 6.
It's a blast. Especially the ones with the slides.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they're the best.
Huh. Well, you see Wimmer there warming up the tires.
For what? We haven't had a long run.
What is a long run?
That is a great question.
Yeah, what
know.
Is a long run? I don't know what that is. Never heard of it.
I'd consider it a long run. I'd say, what do you guys think? 6 laps?
Somewhere around that range.
I may even be pushing it with 6 laps.
Yeah, I think probably 4.
Mm.
Here's the look at the owner points. Right now, Richard Childress on top with 46-11 points. Joe Gibbs is 129 behind with the 20 car of, what's his face? JJ Yaley.
All right, here we go. Let's try it again.
Green flag waves again for about the 500th time today. Rudiman, not as good of a start there.
No, not that great. Franchitti right on his bumper. He tries to come to the inside. I believe that's Brad Keselowski. He tried to cut off there. And now Mike Bliss into third place.
Yeah, Bliss hanging tough on that high line, fighting against the 8-8 of Brad Keselowski. But Keselowski sends it in.
That right there was almost like a 3-car wreck. Keselowski almost took out 2 really good race cars.
Keselowski, no stranger to contact today, was involved in that earlier incident.
Oh.
Here's Leffler in fourth, trying to see what... Wow, these guys doing in front here.
Ooh.
Continuing about side-by-side is Bliss and Keselowski. That's a really good battle.
Game very intriguing so far.
Finally, the 22 rescinds the spot to the 88 as Leffler now in fourth place, looking to get around this 22 if possible.
Oh.
Very interesting camera angle right there.
And that was a very interesting one. I thought the caution was coming out again.
Yeah, I did too. So, would you guys consider this to be a long green flag run at this point?
Yes. Yes.
At this point, yes. It's probably the longest run we've had.
Oh, Leffler with a daring move! 22! Wow.
That was an aggressive block.
That was close.
That could have been bad right there. Ooh, almost contact right there.
Almost contact with Franchitti and Bliss as they battle for third. And the
caution!
Here's the caution now.
For the record-breaking caution, the 27 goes around.
That car 27 needs car of Brad Baker for Bruco Motorsports. That interesting combination of pink, purple, and yellow.
Mm-hmm,
it's not bad, though.
Let's see here.
Oh, it was a tap from the 21, and also contact with another vehicle.
He was involved. Or not Brad Sweet, Brad Coleman.
Oh, no. Brad.
That's big. That is big. You saw Brad Coleman was putting up a fight with Rudiman earlier in this race, but now with damage, especially to the front end, that's going to create a very uphill battle for this 18 machine.
That 27 car might be going to the garage. I don't think he's going to pit road.
Mm-mm.
You saw him kind of drive toward the 18 before turning back away, so it looks like Tepper's there as well.
Does it look like Rudiman is going to bring it to pit road here?
Would it be the first time today?
Okay. Couple other drivers. Leffler is in here. I think I may have saw Mike Bliss. Not too sure.
I think everyone's coming down, so this is basically everyone's pit stop.
If anyone stays out, just be prepared.
Uh. Just now getting to the left sides on David Ruderman as they put fuel in as well, and he is good to go there in that Aaron's 99 machine.
Good stop there for the 99.
I think Frank Keady might come out in front of the
99.
Yeah, I don't think Ruderman had the greatest of stops.
I think someone was playing strategy.
Yeah, that was a big gap right there.
Oh, I lied. Ruderman had a decent stop. But yeah, you're right. Marlin, apparently, I may have taken two tires there. Same for Miller in the 77, who was involved in an earlier yellow. But who hasn't at this point? And Bliss falls four spots during that pit stop cycle.
He and Jason Leffler are not really that great of a stop.
Yeah.
We'll be back after a break. There's the one car, by the way. It's pretty sexy. All right. Back. The 11 car in the 56, third and fourth there, but the current leader of this race is the 88 machine, I believe, of Brad Keselowski. Stephen Light.
He stayed out.
Yeah, Brad Keselowski, I believe, is either on the tail end of the lead lap or one lap down, I believe.
Yeah, see, this is why they don't promote me to lead as often anymore. But anyway,
here, look at the 59 Marcus
Ambrose as well.
He's finally back up front again. Back up where he started. It's a lot of damage to the right side of the 59 there for Ambrose.
I was just about to point that out. You see all that damage marks on the right side of that car, just behind the right front tire on the door number as well.
I mean, in-plane strategy will definitely give him an opportunity to get back in the picture, because that 59 car has definitely not been up to par. He started on pole and just basically faded out since then, and with this caution coming out and him staying out, this is basically
Look
the best
out.
Chance in the turn.
Oh, that was close.
Sterling Marlin, I believe, right there, nearly got doored there.
Oh.
Carl Edwards and his journey to the front.
Yeah, his very long journey to the front. Now back
to
the
19th.
I believe he may have pitted.
Here's the Leffler.
Getting passed by teammate in the 6, David Reagan, it looks like.
I will say, the field is honestly doing really solid right now, as I say that.
Don't jinx it now, Tyler Skosen. Don't jinx
it! It's trying to go.
Oh,
never mind. Oh, and there's Ron Young again. And
49 is
Ron
Young spins.
And Ron Young and Brian Keselowski. And Cole!
Oh, Cole!
Oh, no! And I was about to point out, I noticed when we cut away from that onboard. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, we can
the one hour of Sterling Marlin as well.
Sterling Marlin,
Lord.
Brad Keselowski, and not Brad Keselowski, Carl Edwards, and can't really tell who that third car is right there. Big damage to the 60 of Edwards.
Mm. I think he's staying this race, but he's going to possibly lose a lap or two if his team can't fix it quite quickly.
If you saw that onboard, as
well. Oh, and there he goes!
Oh, he's
there.
Oh, yeah.
Carl.
Oh, no.
Carl, the caution's already out. You don't need to floor it or anything.
Oh, there's more smoke on the back. Don't know what that's from.
At least we're over halfway, finally.
Oh, just...
he's staying out?
I don't know what's going on. Who's lingering all that smoke? Dear Lord.
I don't know. Someone finally on... I can't... Oh, my.
Is someone on fire?
I don't know. But my question is, why on earth is Carl Edwards not pitting is my question.
I believe he doesn't think the damage is bad.
I mean, first he was in the inside one, then he just looped it under caution. Let's see what happened here. Three wide,
out of room, 71 gets turned, and then 49 also gets turned around in the back. As for the 60 and the other cars involved, I would assume it's probably a product of the smoke and just
here we go.
That large
see.
Path
here we go.
He was racing in.
Checked up for Carl here.
Oh, the one up underneath by whoever was behind him.
It was probably that.
Far from behind because Sterling Marlin was stopping the little racetrack.
Yeah, Sterling was stopped there. Carl was on the brakes already, but the person behind him had no idea and ran right into the 60.
What caused Marlin to spin? My question.
Not too sure. Oh, now he's bringing it to pits.
That's definitely more than not too bad damage.
Yeah, definitely seems like it's a little bit worse than I kind of thought.
He got all that left front damage as well as the damage to the rear when he just got clobbered by that other car. This is kind of big for the championship, even though it seems like that it's pretty much done and over with Carl. I mean, Rudiman is winning this race right now, and now you see Edwards here back to 33rd.
I will say, even though the Drivers' Championship is going to be, you know, looking good for Carl, the owner's title, definitely this is going to be hurting the 60 and Jack Roush here. This is probably going to put him way further behind to catch Richard Childress.
Yeah, with Wimmer running pretty well today as well. You're going to need him to get involved in some sort of accident to stay reasonably within limits of the 29.
I mean, I guess with what we've been seeing today in this race, that's definitely not out of the question.
Well, this race is just chaotic. I think it's going to pick a lot more, but Carl's definitely got a lot of damage on that car. But I think he can try to continue, but damage does look a little severe.
I mean, I guess he's just going to have to hope for no tire rubs.
Yeah.
You saw that great angle with Cameron Cobb, the tire changer or something like that. We'll be back. Welcome back as we take a look at the 42 of Dario Franchitti. He's been running well all day. Once again, I'm Carter Jones. Don't worry about the radio communications. I'm Carter Jones alongside Tyler Skozen and Tanner Campos. Quite the day. Cautions breed cautions. Tanner alluded to that earlier. Just cautions breeding cautions.
Yeah. And just like what Dario Franchitti just said, that just summarized how this race is going.
Yeah, it's been as high as second, started third, been down as low as 15th, but it's currently just outside the top 10 in 11th.
I will say, though, for the amount of cautions and incidents we've had today, that 42 car is actually fairly clean on the left side, as it looks like they're going to bring them to a stop.
That was a pretty large-scale accident that did occur on the front stretch. And you saw all that smoke being laid down. I assume oil may have been put down as well, as we saw Carl spin after the yellow had flown. So maybe there's oil they'll have to get cleaned up here at Memphis. See Dario there.
He's probably talking about race strategy for later. I mean, if all these cautions continue to keep coming out, definitely is going to be changing probably a lot of strategies within the field. There's a lot of rookie drivers making a lot of rookie
mistakes. And we talked earlier. They continue to come to a stop here. Safety trucks going to get going here. There you go. 15 cautions yep. Today. Season high and record for Memphis.
GG.
Now I ask you guys, do you think we could compete with the all-time record?
I think we could. The race is pretty chaotic, so we can possibly get there, but only time will tell.
Yeah, I agree. I think we do have a good chance, especially with all the racing and aggressiveness we've had today.
Pretty hot, humid day here at Memphis. Safety workers getting them bottled waters out to every driver. Keep them hydrated so they don't die behind the wheel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're going to need that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, someone dropped a bottle!
Oh, well, now it's broken.
Blew it on the track. Thanks, NASCAR officials.
Let's take a look at this. Young drivers in Memphis, 21 and younger. It's really crazy how the youth movement is here in the what we call it, the Busch Series. Yeah, Landon Castle, 18 years old. Clawson and Chase Austin as well. He saw Chase doing really well earlier in this race before he got involved in a couple accidents.
And we'll see half that graphic be covered in white because all the rookie and young drivers have just been involved in an incident.
Not bad for Colin Braun and Brad Coleman. Obviously, we saw Coleman, I think, in maybe a little bit of damage earlier. Couldn't really tell, but not bad.
Yeah, good job by Stephen Light right there, as well as David Reagan for keeping it clean today. That's really all you can ask for from a rookie is keeping it clean, as we'll be back here at Memphis. And welcome back. I thought the pace car was going to run someone over there, but it's okay. This is the Samstown 250 for the NASCAR Busch Series. The year is 2007. Times are great. The crowd is wild. COVID is non-existent, and we're vibing.
What's COVID?
Yeah, I don't know. I was about to ask you. Where did that word come from?
This is 2007. I don't even know what the future holds.
Yeah, I don't know either. That goes for Brad Keselowski's career as well. Here's a recap. Crashes, more crashes. Clausen, the 71. You saw Krisloff there as well. It wasn't done. The 43 went around. Then we saw the 64 of Chase Young. The 71 once again involving the 9 of Chase Miller. We saw Stephen Wallace spin into the outside wall as well. Landon Castle go for a spin, the young 18-year-old. Once again, the 71 going for another slide. And then Mike Bliss and Carl Edwards getting into it in that same incident.
What you just summarized is basically how this race is going. Spin, 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 spin.
Yep.
Just huh. Look at that little stat right there.
Oh my lord!
Laps of caution laps. Oh my!
I'm surprised
lord.
We've had 66 wow. green flag laps. If I'm being honest,
I am too. Actually,
now we have 69 laps under yellow.
Nice. All right. Well, one to go here before the next restart and perhaps the next caution as well. You see, the 38's got quite a bit of damage. That's Leffler. Sorry.
Yeah. He's currently sitting outside the top 10, just barely inside the top 15. He's been a contender all day today. I thought he's definitely had a good chance to, you know, compete with David Ruderman, but obviously now he's found himself a little bit further in the pack. Hopefully no incidents occur around him like we saw, like that I thought with Carl Edwards until he got into an issue.
Yeah, that was certainly a pretty big turning point for this race. Now, Ruderman's closest competition would have to be just continue to be that 42 of Dario Franchitti.
Basically.
Continuing to warm up their tires, get the track a bit more clean before the restart. Here's an interview.
You go back green here. How did you come to the decision?
Well, first of all, Stephen Light's done a very good job today for us, and Robert Yates Racing, his City Financial Ford Fusion crew, has done a good, done a really good job today. Sometimes the crew chief, you know, he's the one that has to make decisions. Sometimes when you have a good crew behind you, you know, you can gather everybody up and say, what do you want to do, guys? And collectively, we've come to a decision. So I think we'll be good. We've had a good day so far. The crew's done a good job, so we'll be good.
So you wanted to stay out. Steven wanted to come in. Everybody else voted to stay out, so you're going to do what?
Yeah, I can stay out. I can go a ways on fuel, and I got tires left, so I want to try and get off sequence with them, so... I wanted to stay out, so I'm going to stay out.
Yeah, there you go. Stephen Light, just 20 years old. He won the race at Kentucky earlier this season.
In the 90 of Stephen Light, you heard from his crew chief that was there. He currently leads here. It's pretty crazy, if I say so myself.
Yeah. He's playing the strategy right. He's planning ahead to all the accidents happening, and he's found himself in the lead.
Now get this, only 2 top 10 finishes in 15 Busch Series races since his prior win at Kentucky. So, Stephen Light's been on a bit of a downfall as of late, looking for a resurgence here today. And what better way to do that than with a win here, if he could somehow hold off Ruderman, who's making a charge back from 8th right now.
Stephen Light definitely needs to get his career turned around, because he's supposed to be the face of... the future face of Robert Yates Racing, because that team has definitely fallen off the map within the last few years. And with David Gillen basically taking over Elliott Sadler's old spot, that I would assume that 88 or whatever number that's going to be next year will be Stephen Light's spot. But only time will tell on when that announcement will come. But Stephen Light definitely needs to get his act together.
See, Carl, still with a significant amount of damage, going to get more work done to this Scott's machine. Now, Carl's been pretty impressive in this series. He's also been pretty impressive in Cup. Put a fight up against Jimmy Johnson for the championship. What do you guys think?
Pressure in my life. I don't, you know, I've put pressure on myself from day one, you know, no matter what I was racing in. And I have a certain amount that I let myself feel, and anything beyond that, I don't really, you know, I don't really let in. So. The idea that we could win all these things and it could be so great, that's great. That's a great goal, but I try really hard not to let that affect, you know, my racing and not to let it affect me personally. But it is, you know, I think about it a little bit, but I got to be careful how much I think about it. And Carl gets some more.
I wonder how Carl Edwards' career is going to unfold as he continues to find success here and perhaps future success in the Cup Series. I think he's title bound, but I don't know.
If you ask me, I think Carl Edwards can at least win a Cup Series title. I'd be shocked if he doesn't, honestly.
And you know what's really entertaining about Carl? You know what's really entertaining about Carl is that backflip, man. Never gets old.
I wonder if anyone else will ever do the backflip once Carl's gone.
Nah, I wonder as well. It's probably just going to be his thing. I don't think anyone would do that.
Yeah, and even if someone had a backflip celebration, I just don't think it'd be right for them to ever win a race.
No.
True.
I don't think they'll ever win anything in their career.
No, probably not even a championship.
No, the one driver that could do a backflip like Carl Edwards is a driver who just probably won't win anything.
Yeah.
True.
That do be how it be. Gonna come to one to go here until the restart. So we'll be back after another break. Well, we've returned from said break, and we are back green in the Samtown 250 in the most yellow-infested race I think I've ever seen.
Steven Light currently holding the lead. Let's see if he's going to be able to keep it. Their double file looks like we're out two rows behind them.
Oh.
Here comes Wimmer, it looks like, trying to get to the inside.
Oh, yeah, we're in the yellow and green Holiday Inn machine making a move.
This is a battle right here. David Rudiman, this is probably the first time he's probably had competition probably most of this race.
He's got to earn this win a little bit. He's at least he's getting his elbows out, and he's on the hunt for Steven Light because that 99 car is bad fast today.
Mm. You can say that again. He's currently third. He's hanging tough with Rudiman, who's somehow driven his way up to second already.
You kind of got a four-car breakaway. You got Light leading, then you got Rudiman trying to gain on, then you got Scott Wimmer trying to hold tight with them, and then I believe Mike Bliss right behind Wimmer. So you got a four cars under a break. And look at this stat. Only driver with top 10 finish in all five Busch races. That's pretty impressive, honestly.
That is crazy, especially with how caution-infested these races are. To find success in each and every one of them so far is impressive.
Oh, look at that. David Raymond's already back to the race.
Not even Steven Light. What?
I guess Steven probably pitted or had enough.
Yeah, he probably gave up. Anyway, he passes Jason Keller for the lead.
I can't say I'm surprised.
No, yeah, I'm not either. This has really been David Raymond's race from start to finish.
But what I will say I'm surprised about, do I dare say it?
What?
Do it.
Okay, I'll do it. The lack of yellows in this run.
That is true. We have not had a yellow in, I'd say, a couple laps. Couple meaning, you know, not too long ago, but...
I mean, you're starting to see guys that have been involved in spins and wrecks start to make their way back to the top 10 with how many there are. You saw Landon Castle currently 9th, Keselowski 14th. Frank, he's fallen to 15th, unfortunately. And the 21's been involved in a couple of skirmishes today, riding in the top 20 and 18th right now.
And even look at Carl Edwards there. He's still managing to sit in 20th because probably everyone else behind him is either off pace
Mike Wallace around. Another one also going around.
Oh,
that is Edwards.
Oh, it's Carl again.
Oh, it's Carl again.
My lord. Oh, he's looking for somebody.
Oh,
where's Carl going?
Someone. Carl, thanks,
okay,
smart.
Okay, he's not after his teammate.
Carl.
Who's he going after? Here, buddy.
Who is he looking for?
Carl, calm down. Is he mad at someone, or was he just getting
I don't know. It's kind of unclear.
Let's see what happened here. Oh.
Mike Wallace turned
Gale
around there.
I believe that was Gale. Gale. There's Carl
there
on the inside.
Look at that smoke show. That is covering the entire exit of turn 4.
Mm-hmm.
Woo! That was on board with Mike Wallace.
That was a very nice spin right there, though. That
was
really nice.
All right. This is Cale Gayle.
Not even the biggest hit either. That was just a small touch and just got him spun around.
Yep.
That's the things with these cars is that they spin very easily with just the slightest butt touch.
Oh, there goes Keselowski around as well. He's involved. There's Carl. He got hit from behind. Looks like Chase Miller got into the back of him.
It looks like it. I think Carl has
a smoke show. Sorry.
I mean, Carl doesn't have much damage, so he might be fine.
Yeah, he's probably fine. It's probably all just the damage that he got from earlier.
Despite the smoke show, only about 3 to 4 cars involved in that one, thankfully. So we continue to race on here, or we will continue the race eventually, as you see the wounded 60 car. And the unwounded and rather healthy-looking Stellar 99 of David Rudiman, who still has yet to win his first race in this series.
I mean, it would be a great day to get that first career win. I mean, he's definitely been the fastest car, so I would assume the trophy is basically waiting for him.
And it certainly probably, would be a deserving one.
They probably have his name engraved on the trophy already.
Probably. Here comes Jason Keller back down pit road along with Jason Leffler.
It's going to hurt their track position a little bit here.
Man, great clips. I tell you what, very reliable. I go there, get a nice haircut every time. Never had a bad experience, except for once. They didn't cut it short enough.
You know, I've gone there, and they've done a mustache trim. Not bad, honestly.
You don't even have a mustache.
Yes, I do. The only way I don't have one because they shaved it off for me.
Sure. I've never seen you wear a
Did you tell them to shave it off?
Yeah, I did.
Why?
You don't even know how to use razors.
Yeah, wait, they know I don't, so I made them do it.
Wow, lazy.
Because if I were to shave my mustache off, I probably would cut my lip, most likely.
Not the lip.
Yeah, well.
You're not shaving your lip.
Well, I probably would have. Let's see, look at this. Has led 119 out of 178 laps. I'm honestly surprised he has not led more.
Yeah, that's hard to believe he's only led 2/3 of the race. But then again, he was behind after that pit stop where Light and others led for a small portion of the race, and that's added up, apparently, to have 60 laps led by other people that aren't David Rudiman.
Well, it looks like we're going to be coming to green here very soon with about 70 and few laps to go, so we're finally getting to the end here.
At the top three, you see the fuel window is pretty similar with Rudiman, Wimmer, and Mike Bliss in the 22.
I highly doubt they'll have to pit again because they're coming down to the nitty-gritty, and plus these yellows are going to help them. So I don't think fuel will be much of a problem.
Nah, it's just going to be a matter of, you know, if they're too aggressive, we do have a semi-decent long run, depending on how much they use up their tires here.
It'll depend on how the run goes.
Yeah.
Depends if they keep it clean as well. Depends on how aggressive they get with each other.
Fair point.
I wish we had a graphic. I don't know if you have one, and I just missed it, of what the longest green flag run we've had today is so far.
I'm very curious.
I'd really love to know.
Same.
Well, 70 to go. Hard to believe at Memphis. We've done 180 laps of action, and we are getting down to it. Finally. It's either going to be the longest 70 laps, or we're just randomly not going to get any more cautions, and it goes by in a blink of an eye. But we'll see how that goes. I honestly doubt that second one, but you never know.
I definitely think we're going to get some more cautions here. Don't know how many. I don't want to take a guess.
I'll go a solid 8 more. Maybe 9 if we're lucky.
I agree. I'll go with that. Here we go. Let's go green.
Green, green, green! Here we go. A nice amount of laps to go.
I saw Rudiman trying to check the field up a little bit, but it didn't really work because Scott Wimmer's like close to him.
Yeah, Scott Wimmer had a pretty decent restart there.
I thought someone got sideways off the corner, but apparently they kept it straight. On board with Jamie Mack in fourth
Look
place.
Look at the lay. Here's my pick. My pick is up front.
Man, Jamie's been in the back all day, and now he's finally showing up. So I guess all those strategies and avoiding all that chaos has really benefited him a lot. I wouldn't be surprised if he has something to say to that 99 car.
You know, I hate to say it because I picked him and now he's running in fourth. I feel like that's a bad sign.
A bad omen, perhaps? With how many jinxes have gone on today?
Yeah.
I mean, Chase Austin ran. So, okay then.
Yeah, we're going to take a look at the double duty drivers because I thought that was pretty cool, but now we have another yellow. It appears to involve the 43 car. Who is this again? Oh, Bobby East. Okay.
Oh, yeah, Bobby
East. Like Bobby West.
Got him! Well, I'll tell you what. Bobby East. Who's better, Bobby East or Bobby Carter?
Ah, oh, man, that's honestly tough to pick. I mean, Bobby Carter is very famous. Let's see what happened here.
Bobby Carter. Oh,
he actually looked that was another behind.
That was another bottleneck effect. He got into the 42, couldn't maintain his speed. I'm sure that checked up the line.
I believe Stephen Wallace
got into him.
Oh, look out, Carl. I think Carl got hit a little bit there again.
It looked like Carl got bumped from behind.
Yeah.
That's something.
I thought Carl was wrecked again, honestly, right there. I don't know how he's 15th.
Good question.
Well, when you're a double-duty driver, got years of cup experience under your belt, I expect nothing less from big boy Carl. We'll be back after this. All right, we hope you enjoyed that word from Duracell. We're back green here in the Samstown 250, the most caution-infested race I've ever seen. I said that already.
Oh!
Can't be said enough, though.
Mike Bliss up the track a little bit there. Lop car Cale Gill there, fourth car in line. Bliss having a little bit of a run here, maybe on the back bumper trying to get around Scott Wimmer.
Yeah, I'm glad you're commentating this for me at the moment, Tyler, because I'm just so drained with all the cautions we've had. Holy crap, I do agree.
Let's hope Cale Gale here doesn't do anything to these lead cars so anything big doesn't happen.
All right, in case you're wondering where Tanner Campos had to go, he had to take a poop, so he'll be back, hopefully.
Mm-hmm.
Reagan with a move to the inside of the 20 of Yaley.
Is it bad that now at this point, every time I see cars go side by side, I'm worried?
Yeah, I mean, no. That's totally the Dollar General 77 machine. Man, what a hard hit that was. That just can't hit the wall.
Brandon Miller for... Oh, a little damage to Dario Franchitti.
Oh, that would be the first time he gets any sustainable damage on that 42. Let's see.
Was he the one? It looks like he was the one.
Oh, what in the world?
Dario, I don't know. Oh, wow. Hard hit there.
That's kind of a shocking move. I don't know why or what the intentions were behind that.
I agree. I don't know what Dario was trying to do there. That was a really big send. He really, from the looks of it, he didn't look like, even if he car was on the inside, he was not going to make the corner.
Well, a stunning turn of events. But then again, we've had about 15 of those in this race, so... Whew. I need to catch my breath. This is too much. I'm obese. This is hard. Make sure to drink water, by the way. Drinking water is good. Tanner's back from his poop. You still with us?
I'm here. I'll continue.
All right. You're still watching the same race we are?
Yeah.
Cool.
What part of the race are you at?
We're at 124.08.
124.08.
Yep.
Should we pause and pick a time?
No, we're not going to pause. We're just going to keep going here. Don't worry, guys. This is normal.
What was the seconds?
All right. Now it's 124.24.
Okay, hold on.
27, 28, 29.
You got it?
You on pace now?
Yeah. I'm on pace.
Cool. All right, well, anyway, pretend you guys never heard that. Dario Franchitti is getting his service done on pit road, 14 seconds into the pit stop, pulling the fender out on the right front. Big man going around, going to get the jack. Woo, it's off. They go around to the left side now. Woo-hoo, hustle up, big boy. Get that jack up. Tires up. Tires out, rather. And they're getting the tape on, getting all that good stuff. A half minute has elapsed in this pit stop. He is being held.
Oh,
I just now realized.
I mean, he pretty much dumped Brandon Miller, so.
Yeah. You know, it's crazy. Crazy how much these cars are being held. I mean, oh, shoot. If you heard an alarm, don't mind that.
I can't say I'm surprised.
No.
At this rate, every driver should be punished at this race for how this race has gone.
Or should be embarrassed by these drivers.
Yeah,
is this a disgrace?
What happened?
I mean,
Okay, that's a replay from earlier.
I thought that was true.
Oh, yeah, that was from earlier in the race.
Keselowski getting into, I believe, what was that, Mike Wallace?
Yep. Crazy stuff.
Definitely an eventful day here.
An eventful is quite the understatement. Quite the chaotic day.
I'm only just now getting to catch my breath under caution, but yet we've had 14 other cautions, and I haven't had a chance to catch my breath. What?
Tanner Campos, would you say this is doomsday for NASCAR? Not literally, but like the doomsday personification of a race?
This is definitely a doomsday. I did not expect this race to be half the chaotic as this, and I believe we're almost to 20 cautions. I did not expect this at all.
I don't think anyone did coming into this.
No.
The Cup Series all-time record for cautions is 22. Could we perhaps elapse that in this race?
Yes. Just yes, I think we can. I mean, we got, what, 55 to go, and I don't know how many we are away, maybe 5 or 6 away?
Who knows? I know we're at 55 to go.
Here's a look at the Indy 500 winners that have been in NASCAR this season. Jacques Villeneuve, of course, won it in 1995, finished 21st at Dega. Buddy Lazier made a start at Vegas. Juan Pablo Montoya, 2 wins, 1 in Cup, 1 in Busch. Sam Hornish Jr., the hot man himself, 6 Busch Series starts, no success yet. And, of course, Dario Franchitti has been running well, but just got involved in that latest accident. He finished 33rd in the Truck Series, I think that was, at Martinsville. But here he is now in the Busch Series. 42 car.
Are you being penalized, Tony?
Yeah, they're holding us a lap for, I guess, aggressive driving. And what really happened, the brake pedal started going down, and, you know, he just went in the corner and didn't have any brakes.
All things considered, what's been your impression of Dario's run today?
He's done a great job so far. You know, unfortunately, we got into 77. I hate that, but, you know, certainly he didn't mean to. Again, he just lost his brake. The brake pedal went down. So try to get her to the end, try to get her lap back.
Marty, you think all these Indy guys that win the...
Damn. All right, you heard it there from the man himself. As the sun is starting to set, is daylight perhaps an issue here?
I mean, if we keep having cautions like this, it probably will be at this rate.
Man, just craziness all around.
Gonna go green this time by.
Yep, half a lap to go. Rudiman continues to lead in his reign of terror. Scott Wimmer in second, the Holiday Inn machine, and then Mike Bliss, third in the 22 car. There's Marcos Ambrose, in case you're curious where he was.
Let's see what Cale Gill, the lap car, does on the inside here. See if he races anyone aggressive. Nope.
Here we go. Restarting here with 52 to go now.
Look at Wimmer right on the back bumper there on the 99. Good restart for Scott.
In a turn three, Rudiman holding the 29 at bay. You mentioned Gale. He kind of moved over, but now he's kind of hanging tough there with the third place of Mike Bliss. Oh, in turn one, Franchitti involved. The 37 as well.
Well.
Caution? Oh, there it is.
Yeah, caution.
crazy, crazy stuff, man.
Caution, free caution.
Frank Keady's involved. That was John Graham in the 37. He was around.
And yet another restart. I wonder what David Ruderman thinks, having to just not having the opportunity to pull away, just win this race for himself, just having to continually nail each restart. Oh, we'll be back, by the way. This is the Samstown 250. And welcome back. 42 getting service done here on pit road after he was involved in the latest caution.
Good day, gone to a bad day.
As is the case with several other drivers.
The only person who hasn't had that motto to them is probably David Ruderman. Probably the only one that hasn't had that happen.
No, David Ruderman basically avoided everything.
I will say, though, I feel like the only way David Ruderman, one of two ways David Ruderman gets beat today is strategy, where he maybe pits again for some reason, or someone hits him. I think that's the only way he gets beat today. They're going to need to hit him to get by him.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, he's just been the class of the field all day, even despite having the shuffling of the running order, having to pit, lots of cars staying out. Ruderman still finds a way to lead the pack. Here's a look at the six of David Reagan. Teammate of Carl Edwards, who's been involved in a lot today.
Yep.
Good run for David today.
Yeah.
Started towards the back of the field, and now he's into the top 10, I believe. So,
I know. Going. My bad.
You know it's a good run when he's kept it clean at this point.
That's true. I mean, David Reagan's had a great day. He was in the back early on, but that team got that car perfectly set up for the end of this race. So I think David Reagan might have a good chance of having a good finish or possibly win the race.
Green flag back out.
Let's give it a try. Let's see how many laps we go here. Here goes Bliss to the inside of Cale Gayle. Remember, lap car. He's not for position. Oh, three wide. Frank Keady. Frank Keady. He's bringing pit road. Tire looks like it's down.
It's down.
Yep. Left front tire flat for Frank Keady, and he's going to bring it to pit road. And that's pretty much going to finish his day.
Oh,
definitely.
Those rookie stripes have definitely gotten beaten up today.
That's for sure. There's JJ Yaley, David Reagan to the inside, trying to get by the lap car. Cale Gayle, Marcus Ambrose trying to follow. Oh, car around.
Whoa.
21 car, sideways caution.
It's a 21.
There it is. For the at least we've had practice saying the word caution today. I will say that.
Oh, definitely. Definitely been one of those days.
Yep. Unbelievable. Not too sure what caused that caution there.
Probably got turned because it's basically been everyone. It's been the spin cycle today. It's basically been a...
There you go. There's the record. Most cautions, 26 at Hickory in 1992. We currently sit at 22 right now. We need 4 to tie that. You think we can do that?
I mean, we could. There's a possibility. But, I mean, we're getting down to the nitty-gritty. We don't know how many more cautions we might expect in this race.
There's a 21. McCready just got to the inside and got sideways, lost it.
Hillary got in the grass.
Chase Miller. Looks like he got loose underneath. Got loose. Yeah. And for those wondering where Carter went, he also had to go take a poo, so.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And it looks like, are we already going back? Hey, we're all, okay, and we're back green already. Here we go. 40 to go.
Yep, we're going green again.
Ruderman, a good restart. Here's Wimmer in second. K.
Mikhail Gale looks like he's going to roll over and give the spot to Mike Bliss. Comes McMurray. He's still up in the mix, up in fourth place. Good run for McMurray today.
He's trying to use that high line. I see what he's trying to do. He's trying to gain a little more speed exiting the corners. I mean, it helped him a little bit, but it's not helping him that much. But he's getting around Kale Gale, it looks like. But I don't know if he can do much with it.
And what we were just looking at, Carl Edwards, with the day he has had, he is somehow miraculously in the 11th position.
How is Carl doing this?
I don't know how he's doing it, but... I mean, I guess with all the cautions and incidents with other cars, that's honestly, I guess, what's giving him all these positions. Currently sitting 11th and a bunch of cars in front of him that he can get by.
He's got that speed.
He's even holding good speed. Oh, near contact right there. Jason Keller got the bump from behind, it looks like.
Oh, Steven.
Oh.
Oh.
Carl trying to get around. Looks like Steven Light now. He's into the 10th position. Trying to get around Light.
He's using that brake throttle. He's trying to maintain that speed a little bit while not trying to get run into from behind. I see what he's trying to do. It's working out for him.
Up front, Rudiman has pulled away a little bit to pretty decent lead, and it's a three-car breakaway.
I have returned.
Oh, he's welcome back from his poop. Welcome.
In my defense... This wouldn't have happened if there wasn't 20 million cautions in this race.
Will say there was no caution since you've been gone. So,
you sure about that?
I'm sure. As weird as this may sound, this may be the longest green flag run of the day.
Really?
Yes.
That's crazy.
JJ Yaley thing.
Yeah, let's get back in the groove of things. It appears. Is McMurray leading this thing?
No, sorry. It's David Roman. I forgot David Roman.
Yeah, three-car breakaway.
Okay.
And we only need four more cautions to tie the record for most cautions in a race. We currently sit 22.
I think we're capable.
It's possible, but only time will tell.
Oh, and look at this. Look at this, Carter. You notice Carl Edwards? Look where he is. Look what position he's in.
Top 10, no way.
Yep.
Yeah, Carl is charging.
Carl Edwards is miraculously in 10th place. Oh my, what just happened?
With a damaged race car, out of all things.
A broken race car.
Yeah, half broken.
Mm-hmm. Looks like he's... Oh, he may get past. Look out.
Castle with the aggressive move to the bumper of the 60 car.
Be careful, Carl. You don't want to get spun out.
Carl was good on the short run. Now I think as a long run. It's
the yellow.
Never mind.
Colin Brown involved.
Is that Frank? No, that's the 43.
No,
I think.
East again.
It's the 43.
All right, that's caution. What is it? What did I say? 23 now, I believe?
This is caution 23.
Yep, 23. Ugh. Hey, we're 30 laps to go, finally.
We even make it there without another caution?
No.
Look at the replay. The 71 slides up, creates a checkup, and that's pretty much what we've seen with a lot of incidents today.
Yeah.
I mean, Ron Young's basically been in everything.
Yeah. Oh, look, he just climbed on the car there. So I'll catch my breath now again.
You gotta catch your breath.
I think, as weird as this may sound, this may get interesting for the lead now as we hit under 30 to go. I don't know.
Oh, man. I had to wait for another minute again. I'm sorry.
It's fine. We'll cover you.
That's why they call us the most professional team in the business, though. We're back green here.
Tanya, these guys like Wimmer and Bliss, they've got to hit David Rudiman at this.
They have to. They have to punt him. They can't just be calm anymore. They have to move him.
Man, I'm thinking they can get to the bumper to move them, though, is the thing.
Yeah, true. That 99 car has something under the hood and easily pulling away from the competition. I don't even think Wimmer has anything for him. He'll basically have to send it while wrecking himself in the process.
And that wouldn't be good for either of them. You saw a slow car there on the apron entering turn three. Hopefully that doesn't prompt a yellow.
Look at David Reagan there. Now I think in fifth place, looking to get by Jamie McMurray for fourth. Oh, barely.
Oh, Jamie.
Marcus Ambrose is back in the mix, finally.
Yeah, Ambrose now on attack mode on the six. He dives to the inside. Will it make anything? Nope. It didn't.
No, not quite.
Oh, Marcus.
Oh.
Oh, almost into the wall there. As the great clips 38 machine, Jason Loeffler makes the move back on the
thing. He's getting a little feisty.
Good move by Loeffler. That was actually a clean pass right there.
I mean, he had to use a little aggression, but it definitely was mostly clean.
And Loeffler currently sixth. I almost read that as fourth, but he is in fact sixth. You see right here, another aggressive move. That kind of looked like the 26 of McMurray. Oh, attack
the bumper.
Oh. What did you do?
Very aggressive in nature. He's showing it now as he gets to the inside of the 26. Crunch time, 23 to go at Memphis.
Now, I don't want to jinx it, but these guys, I think, have found their groove here, and I think there's a good chance we could have a decently long run here to the end.
McMurray struggling. He almost hit the wall off four.
McMurray not going really anywhere on that outside. Finally gets to the inside again.
Oh!
Oh, whoa. He may get punted for blocking like that.
The aggression's picking up, so chaos. The intensity is going to pick up as this race goes towards the checker flag, so I wouldn't be surprised if anyone else brings out a caution.
Edwards with an impressive top 10 after being involved in everything ever in this race.
This man just never quit.
Watch Castle, though.
Oh, he may be involved in something else again if Castle gets in the back of him.
Whoa, Castle.
Oh, Landon, calm down here. It's the end of the race. We've had a lot of cautions. Don't bring out another. Surprisingly, look at that at the top of the leaderboard. Only 37th place is out of the race currently.
Wow.
One, two, three, that is four, crazy. Five. Only six cars are out of this race.
That's crazy. I thought at least 20 cars would be in this race still, but it's definitely a surprise to see at least half majority of the field still continuing.
Mm-hmm. Rudiman, pretty big lead. Looking like he's can sail to this win if we get no more cautions.
Yeah, I mean, what else can be said about David Rudiman? He has just been the man today.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, definitely. He's determined to get that checker flag, and he's definitely showing it all day long. And he's just waiting for that checker flag to drop, but he knows there probably will be one more caution for him to have to fight.
Oh, there it is! Stephen Wallace with another spin Stephen on the
Wallace,
day.
Okay.
And make that number bajillion on the commentator jinx scale.
Yep.
I think that's 24?
I believe on the 24th.
Oh, my goodness gracious. So we need two more to tie the record.
Let's go for it. Why not?
Yeah, sure. All right. What happened here to Steven? Well, it looks like he got turned.
Oh, that was not intentional. You can see the brake lock.
Yeah. Got turned.
It looked like Steven came down.
He did. Looks like Brian didn't expect it, I guess. Yeah. He got to the inside and just ran out of room.
And once again, we'll be back after literally another yellow.
Cautions, free cautions.
Yes, they do. We're back here. There's the 99. I'm sure Michael Waltrip is somewhere looking down, smiling at this performance by David Rudiman
today. Probably have to try because he probably failed to make another Cup Series race.
I mean, there's the good luck number. 62 career starts so far. It's today, finally, his first win in the Busch Series.
It's a good restart.
Green again.
definitely a really good restart. Mike Bliss did not get going. Look at David Reagan. Oh,
oh, poor restart.
The inside of Scott Wimmer.
Look at Cale Gayle, maybe trying to race David Ruderman. As long as he doesn't hold up Mike Bliss.
Actually, Mike Bliss, make this interesting.
Mike Bliss actually kind of hanging in there.
Oh, he's using that outside.
Time being, he's holding on, but...
Cale Gayle gives the spot up as a lap car, thankfully. Gives the spot up, so now Bliss can go for it against the 99 of Ruderman.
Oh, he might be able to get to him.
Looks like Carl Edwards, he's going to need it just a couple more spots to hit that magic number. David Reagan third, not bad.
Oh.
Oh, man, almost getting into the 29 there is Loeffler. Wimmer and Loeffler with near contact. I mean, there's been near contact every corner of the track every lap, if we're being honest.
Yeah, yeah. 10 to go. So we're, it sounds like I'm being told Carl needs to finish around 8th to clinch the championship is what I'm hearing.
I believe that is correct.
Oh! Look at Mike Bliss!
Oh!
Mike Bliss
right there
on Ruderman! Is Ruderman gonna choke this?
No.
Actually, that's going, oh, here comes Mike Bliss!
Mike, or not Mike, David Ruderman, you can't choke this, not now!
I mean, he can't choke this at the wrong time.
This would be the
worst. I mean,
Mike
Bliss has something for him.
Maybe Ruderman's friends have been the cautions today. Who knows?
Or they might be his downfall. Because he hasn't had that many since we've come down to the nitty-gritty.
8 to go. Rather, pretty lengthy green flag run. We've seen a few more of them. That
yeah.
typically wouldn't be long, but by standards of this race, it's been pretty long.
Mm-hmm. 7 to go, finally. Wow, last lap, Mike Bliss was quicker than David Ruderman.
Yeah, Mike Bliss, though, was there side-by-side with Ruderman, which was very shocking at first, but
yeah.
since then, lost that ground. Apparently gained a bit that lap. Let's see what he does this lap.
I mean, he might be trying to save something, but I don't know. I think he might have used up everything on that attempt he was doing. But we still have a few laps to go, but I highly doubt Mike Bliss can get back to David Ruderman.
Yeah, it's going to be a tough task with just 6 laps to go here at Memphis.
Oh, Carl's falling.
Carl in 12th, not looking good to clinch his title.
5 to go now for the 99.
Oh, bless you.
Oh, thank you.
I think Mike Bliss is going to need another yellow here.
Yeah, that's the only chance he's going to get. But I don't think he can. I don't think he'll get it.
I don't think so either.
4 to go now. The sun beaming onto this Memphis Motorsports Park as it continues to get darker out.
Here's my question. Does that 99 car have any scratches on it? That's my question.
I don't believe it's been involved in one single incident in this race.
That's incredible.
It is
incredible.
I mean, incredible.
That's the perfection of Aaron's. It's the dream machine. So mm-hmm. perfection's almost guaranteed for it.
Just a spectacular job. Great drive by David Ruderman today. He can just hold on for 3 more laps. He will get his first ever Busch Series win. Did he clip the apron there?
I don't know.
It didn't look like it, but it's whatever.
Don't say that now.
I mean, there's no splitters, so it's not a big deal.
The flag man and looking on, he's like, where is that caution?
Or 2 to go now.
I don't believe it. I think we're going to get to the white flag without a caution.
This would be...
Are you kidding me?
As has been the theme today.
Oh, no.
You was so good.
Ruderman's first win is in jeopardy after that. And you know what? Let's take a break to catch a breath. We'll be back.
Get this finish.
Here we go, back to the restart. Two to go here at Memphis.
Can Bliss get there? Oh, that was a good start by Ruderman, though.
Yeah, that's what Ruderman needed. Good start. He's got about a quarter of a second on Mike Bliss. About five, six car lengths through three and four. Make that 4-3. Leffler falling back. Reagan takes third. White flag flies for the 99 of David Ruderman and that Michael Waltrip racing machine.
Great performance by Ruderman today. Great. He's played the strategies right, played the cautions right. Now he's looking to get his first win.
Oh! A spin in the back! A race tested with yellow after yellow is going to come to a close as the darkness is over Memphis. David Ruderman captures win number one in the NASCAR Busch Series.
Great job. Great job by
Ruderman. What a monstrous performance by that 9-9 team. Well deserved.
Bliss brings it home second, and David Reagan will take the 6th to 3rd place.
I heard Carl Edwards was involved in that caution.
I don't see him on the running order.
No.
And that means, with Ruderman winning this race and Edwards having a poor finish today, that keeps the championship battle alive, but not thriving by any means. Means? I can't talk.
Sure. Impressive, though, by Ruderman. Like I said, played everything right. Yeah. Great job by him and the team, and avoided all the incidents.
Well, and deserved. There he is, celebrating his win, his first ever. Good job by David Ruderman, future Cup prospect, probably future legend and superstar. Thank you guys for tuning in. We have to cut away immediately because of all the cautions that took up all the broadcast time.